In today's video, we will see how to create bulk marksheet with help of Excel and Word file just in a single click. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Monk. Today we will be creating marksheet of class 12th, but by using same technique, you can create any marksheet or invitation cards. Let's start the video without any delays. To create bulk marksheet, we need certain things like signature, a raw copy or raw data, which will be in Word file, an Excel file. The things which we are going to mention in Excel file will be name of the student, roll number, date of birth, father's name, session, maximum marks, name of the subjects, grade of the subjects. So all the subjects are mentioned over here. When we will come ahead, total achieved marks, total marks, percentage achieved by the student or percentage got by the student, grade, pass or fail. So we are going to create this marksheet in Word file. We will have to open a new Word file. Before that, I'll show you how our marksheet is going to appear. This is the marksheet which I have made in Word file and converted in PDF file. So let's start making new marksheet in Word file. Let's open a new Word file. First of all, we will have to go in layout, margins. We will do it narrow. After that, we will be going in insert. We will insert a shape over here. We will fill the shape with some color. I'll be taking this color. I'll be doing it little bit dark. You can choose any color as per your requirement. I'll remove outline. I'll right click the mouse and I'll add text. In text, we will put name of our institute. Under that, I'll be putting certificate of excellence. I'll click over here and I'll change the font. I will change the color also. I'll increase the size of the font. I'll take this little bit down. So this thing is managed. Now we are going to open our raw sheet or data sheet. So both the sheets are over here. Now we have to put marksheet of class 12th. I'll copy this. I'll paste it over here. I'll take this in center. I'll copy all these things and paste it over here. I'll come little bit down. I'll insert a table. Table for subjects and grades. I'll select 6. I'll insert one more. Rows below. Subjects. Maximum marks. Marks achieved. Grade. These two are extra. We will delete it. We will manage this properly. We will align this. Now we have to put name of the subjects. Mathematics, science, social science, English, regional language. We will come down and we will paste these things over there. This thing is done. We will take this. Congratulations for successfully completing the milestone. Wish you bright and successful career ahead and signature. And we will paste this over here. I think all the things are done. We will format this. We will change the font. We will increase the size. We will decrease the size. We will come down. We will insert one more shape. Right click the mouse, add text, office, address. We will change the font color. We will increase this. Font style. We will change color of the shape. We will manage this. Underline. Now we have to insert few more things like watermark, signature and company logo. We will go in design. On the right hand side, we will get the option of watermark. We have to go in text. From drop down, we will select confidential and we will select diagonal as orientation. We will do OK. So our watermark is inserted over here. Now we will go in insert, picture, picture from file, and we will select our logo. When we will insert our logo, we find that logo is too big. When we will resize the logo and try to position the logo as per our requirement, we are not able to do so. We have to right click on the logo. We have to go in wrap text and we have to click or select in front of text. Now we can resize our logo and we can put as per our requirement. So we will place it over here. Once the positioning is done, it's time to insert our signature. We will go in picture, picture from file, and from here we will select our signature. Again we get the same thing, our signature is too big. We will right click on the signature, wrap text in front of text. Now we can resize it properly. We can reposition our logo, but I'll put a line under signature. Good to go. We will increase the size. So mostly the formatting part is done. Few more things are left, like total marks. Total marks is 500. Session, it's 2022-2023. Date, we will put today's date. Maximum marks, maximum mark of each subject is 100. We will select all this and we will align it in center. So all the formatting is done now. We have to click on name. We have to go in mailing tab. From here, there is option of select recipients. We have to click over here, use an existing list, and it will divert to our Excel file. We have to click over here, open the file. Yes. Okay. Now we have to go in insert merge field. We have to click on drop down. From here, we have to click on name. So it will be attached with our Excel file, means our Word file will be attached with Excel. Roll number, from here we have to select date of birth, father's name, we have to select from here. So we have to connect all the things from our Excel file. Mathematics marks, mathematics grade. Marks of science, science grade. So in this way, we will select marks and grade of each and every subject. Now we have to come down in percentage. We have to go in insert merge field once again. We have to select percentage from here, pass or fail. Pass or fail. We will check our format once again. We will take it little bit up. We will resize it. Till now it's looking good. Now we will go in preview results. We have to click over here. There are few glitches in our formatting. We will do formatting properly. Now we can see the marks achieved by the student, grade, percentage, pass or fail, name of the student, father's name. Now we have to come over here in finish and merge. We have to click on drop down, edit individual document. We have to click over here and all the marksheets will be created in one click. So all the marksheets are created very properly. We will come down and we will check. So this is our student Aaron. When we will come down, it's Albie. Below that it's Ambrose. To save this in PDF file, we will go in file. We will select save as, and from here we will select PDF, best for printing, export. Yes. If you don't have option of creating PDF files like this, you can choose any other software or you can convert it online. Now we will see how our marksheet looks. So this is the marksheet which we have created right now. In the same way, you can create other marksheets as well as invitation cards.
I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, keep practicing. Bye-bye.